unless you plan to use Windows authentication. Before using radio management remotely, you need to add user accounts. Windows authentication requires a domain controller and access to the Active Directory. Since my radio management server is not connected to any of these, I'm going to create local accounts in radio management using my own credentials. To do this, you need to go to the radio management server application and click on user authorization. Click on the plus button and select add non-domain user. In the pop-up window, enter the chosen username and password. You don't have to enter an email address or name. These are optional. Once you've entered the data, click OK. The user is now added, but there are some settings you might need to change. So click on the user and click on the pen button. You have to tick RM user. You'll also notice that by default, user must change password on next login is ticked. This means that as soon as they log in using the RM client, they'll be prompted to enter a password of their own choosing. You can select RM administrator here, but this can only be selected for local accounts. Once you're happy with these settings, click Save and then Close. Radio management also allows for certificate-based authentication. I have not tried this yet, but essentially, RM server uses the PC certificate to authenticate the computer trying to connect to the server. This can be used in conjunction with password-based authentication.